ओके, सो नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ आइगन वैल्यूज एंड आइगन वेक्टर्स ऑफ सम स्पेशल मैट्रिसेस. सो इफ यू रिमेंबर हर्मिशियन मैट्रिक्स, दैट इज अ मैट्रिक्स हुज कंजुगेट ट्रांसपोज इज इक्वल टू द मैट्रिक्स इटसेल्फ. सो इन दैट पर्टिकुलर केस द आइगन वैल्यूज ऑफ द हर्मिशियन मैट्रिक्स दे आर रियल. नेक्स्ट वी हैव स्क्यू हर्मिशियन मैट्रिक्स. सो फॉर स्क्यू हर्मिशियन मैट्रिक्स द कंजुगेट ट्रांसपोज ऑफ द मैट्रिक्स ए इज इक्वल टू नेगेटिव ऑफ द मैट्रिक्स ए. सो इन दिस केस द आइगन वैल्यूज दे आर ईदर प्योरली इमेजिनरी और दे आर इक्वल टू जीरो. एंड इन द थर्ड केस वेन यू हैव यूनिटरी मैट्रिक्स, सो फॉर यूनिटरी मैट्रिक्स यू हैव दिस कंडीशन. सो इन दैट केस द आइगन वैल्यूज of a unitary matrix have absolute 1. So that means whatever are the eigenvalues, they should be equal to 1. Right? So let's move on to the next result with us. Next, what is the trace of a matrix? So the trace of a matrix, so suppose this lambda 1 up to lambda n, these are the n eigenvalues, these are the n eigenvalues of a n rowed square matrix. A is equal to lambda jk, where some or all of them are equal. We do not know right now whether they are equal or not. Then we have the result that the product of the eigenvalues of A, that is equal to determinant of A, and the sum of the eigenvalues of A is equal to the trace of matrix A, right? So what is the trace of matrix A? Trace of matrix A, that is defined by the sum of the diagonal elements of that matrix. So according to that, product of eigenvalues, that is the determinant of A, and the sum of the eigenvalues, that is the trace of A. So next we have one more result which says that for the inverse of a matrix A, suppose A inverse represent the inverse of a square matrix A. So this inverse exists if and only if all the eigenvalues lambda 1, lambda 2 up to lambda n, suppose these are the eigenvalues of matrix A, are different from 0. Why this is so? It is because what will be the eigenvalues of A? Because the eigenvalues of A inverse, that would be nothing but 1 by lambda 1, 1 by lambda 2 up to 1 by lambda n. So all of them has to be non-zero. Why? Because if any one of them is zero, so that means this quantity, the eigenvalues for matrix A inverse, could not be defined. So in that case, your A inverse could not be defined. So next we have this result. It says that if we have a matrix A which is defined by alpha jk, and it has eigenvalues lambda 1, lambda 2 up to lambda n, say, then the matrix K the matrix A multiplied by some scalar K, so this is some scalar quantity, so this would have eigenvalues which are the eigenvalues of the matrix A, but however, in this case, they are multiplied by k. Right? So, this is the result. For the next result, suppose the matrix A is given to us as the same matrix alpha jk, and if alpha 1 up to alpha n represent the n eigenvalues for this matrix A, then if P is some polynomial, then the matrix P of A has the eigenvalues P lambda j, where j varies from 1 to n. So that means if you substitute the value of matrix into the polynomial, then that polynomial would result in the eigenvalues, which are themselves polynomials, with the eigenvalues substituted within them. Right? So next we have another term defining the multiplicity of the eigenvalues. So here also we have two things. One is the algebraic multiplicity, one is the geometric multiplicity of the eigenvalue. Right? So algebraic multiplicity is the dimension of the eigenspace of A. This is the dimension of the eigenspace of A. Now, what does it mean? Suppose a matrix A have 1 and 2 eigenvalues. Now, corresponding to these eigenvalues, how many eigenvectors are there? So, the number of eigenvectors corresponding to a single eigenvalue, that would come under this geometric multiplicity. And this algebraic multiplicity would be the total number of eigenvalues. So, that means it would be the dimension of your spectrum set. Right? And for the last result, we have the relationship between this algebraic and geometric multiplicity. So it says that the geometric multiplicity of an eigenvalue cannot exceed the algebraic multiplicity. So these are few of the properties for eigenvalues and eigenvectors. And for a more detailed concept on this, you may refer your course on linear algebra. So next we will see what is the relation of this matrix theory with that of operator.